Hello everyone, today we'll talk about the temporal bone. This video was created with support of Medinero.com. The temporal bones are a pair of bilateral symmetrical bones that constitute a large portion of the lateral wall and base of the skull, and contains organs of hearing and balance. It has three parts: pars squamosa, squamous part, pars tympanica, tympanic part, and pars petrosa, petrous part. These parts are connected and form meatus acoustic externus, external acoustic meatus. Traces of their merger are stored as sutures and crevices. Here is fissura petrosquamosa, petrosquamosa fissure. Fissura tympanosquamosa, tympanosquamosa fissure. It divides into fissura petrosquamosa, petrosquamosa fissure, and fissura petrotympanica, petrotympanica fissure. Here is pars squamosa, or squamous part. It has margo parietalis, parietal border, margo sphenoidalis, sphenoidal border, facies temporalis, temporal surface. It has processus zygomaticus, zygomatic process, crista supramastoidea, supramastoid crest, fossa mandibularis, mandibular fossa, tuberculum articularis, articular tubercle. Also here is located spina suprameatica, suprameatal spine, and foveola suprameatica, suprameatica dimple. Here is brain surface, facies cerebralis. It has impressions digitate, finger impressions, and sulcus arteriosus, arterial groove. Here is pars tympanica, tympanic part. Its concave posterior surface forms the anterior wall, floor, and part of the posterior wall of the external acoustic meatus. Here is porus acousticus externus, or external acoustic opening, spina tympanica major and spina tympanica minor, big and small tympanic spine, fissura tympanomastoidea, tympanomastoid fissure, pars petrosa, or petrosa part, is a bone container for hearing and balance organs. It has pyramid and three surfaces: anterior surface, facies anterior, posterior surface, facies posterior, and inferior surface, facies inferior, and three bodies: margo anterior, anterior border, margo superior, superior border, and margo posterior, posterior border. On the anterior surface are located impressio trigemini, the trigeminal impression, eminentia arcuata, arcuate eminence, and tegmen tympani. This bone forms the roof of the middle ear. Here is hiatus canalis nervi petrosi majoris, or hiatus for the greater petrosal nerve, which goes into sulcus nervi petrosi majoris, groove for the greater petrosal nerve, and hiatus canalis nervi petrosi minoris, or hiatus for the lesser petrosal nerve, which goes into insulcus nervi petrosi minoris, or groove for lesser petrosal nerve. Here is apex patis petrosa, or apex of petrous part, on which is located foramen caroticum internum, the anterior opening of the carotid canal. Posterior surface, or facies posterior. Here is located porus acousticus internus, or internal acoustic opening, meatus acousticus internus, or internal acoustic meatus, fossa subarcuata, the subarcuate fossa, and aperture externa canaliculi cochlea, external aperture of vestibular aqueduct. Here is inferior surface. It has processus stellatus, stellate process, foramen stylomastoideum, stylomastoid foramen, fossa jugularis, jugular fossa, in which is located canaliculus mastoideus, mastoid tubule. Foramen caroticum externum, external carotid opening, and fossula petrosa, the petrosal fossula. On the anterior border is located canalis musculotubarius, musculotubule canal. Sulcus sinus petrosi superioris, groove for the superior petrosal sinus. On the posterior border is located sulcus sinus petrosi inferioris, groove for inferior petrosal sinus. Here is process mastoideus, mastoid process, on which is located incisor mastoidea, mastoid notch, and sulcus arteria occipitalis, the occipital groove for the occipital artery. Here is the mastoid foramen from both sides, and sulcus sinus sigmoideum, groove for sigmoid sinus. Also, inside the mastoid process are located cellulae mastoidea, mastoid cells, and antrum mastoideum, mastoid cave. This video was created with support of medunivero.com.